I'm not going to be reading that chapter. I'll just discuss it with you all. Okay, right? Because here the other class has already done it. So we'll just discuss it because you have a test also on Monday, right? So the reading part you can do. We can just do the discussion and the, you know, relevant values that we need to discuss. Okay, so you've read about the first part. Yes. Can anybody tell me what do you think is the most important event that took place in the first part? 100 dresses. Who are the main characters? Yes, we have Wanda, we have, and we have Peggy. Yeah, okay, Miss Mason also. So we have Wanda Petronsky, and she belongs to the Polish American, or you can say basically, yeah, she's from the Polish community. And because of her appearance, and you know, like, yes, so there are two girls in her class particularly who just stop her and ask her questions every day, right? What question do they ask her? How many dresses she has. And then, of course, they ask her about her shoes. And very surprisingly, what does she reply every day? Yes. Okay, fine. Yeah, she has 100 dresses. But looking at her appearance there, like the dress that she's worn, it's faded and she wears the same dress every day. It's very difficult to believe that she has 100 dresses in her closet. Okay, right? So, and but surprisingly, she describes the beautiful dresses also, right? So she describes them, the color, the material, so velvet and silk and blue and green, all these dresses she describes. She also talks about her shoes also. Now we are here, you know, like aware of the behavior of these three girls, Maddie, Peggy, together asking Wanda questions every day. Wanda silently answering those questions, and then she goes and sits quietly in the corner of the classroom, right? And do you think she has any friends in the class? No, she goes there and sits quietly. Now, at the end of the first part, we come to know that a drawing competition had been announced for the girls and for the boys also. The girls had to paint the dresses and the boys had to design the motorboats, right? So, of course, I have discussed in my class also that how stereotypical it is. Yes? Do you really think it? What is a stereotype kind of a behavior? What's a stereotype kind of a behavior? What is a stereotype? No. Yes, Jasleen? Yes, when a certain kind of behavior is expected from, you can say, certain gender, right? So like girls are expected to behave like this and boys are expected to behave like that. Girls are supposed to be very sensitive and delicate and boys should never cry, right? Girls should play with dolls and boys should play with cars. Girls should wear pink and boys should wear blue. So we have decided, right, even though maybe that girl does not like pink at all, but yeah, of course, we assume that this is what they like to wear. So stereotype here. So when we talk about this competition also, why couldn't it have been the other way around? Why couldn't have the girls asked to be designing, you know, motorboats and the boys designing dresses? And if we look around in the world today, we have so many male designers. We have so many male chefs, right? We have girls breaking all barriers and winning medals for us, isn't it? That means all the gender stereotypes that are there in society, they are created by us. So we only have made these kind of borders and boundaries that this is the way you are expected to behave and this is the way that you have to perform and act in society. Okay, right? Now, when the girls reached the classroom, so when we start the second part, it is there that they reach the classroom and they're very surprised to see. What do they see in the class? They see hundreds of dresses, right? It was going to be the day the result was going to be announced. who is expecting to win this competition? Peggy. Because Peggy is smart. Peggy is there, one of the most popular girls of the school. Peggy is there, you know, like, of course, she does not like seeing anybody hurt children. She cannot tolerate cruelty towards animals. But look at her behavior herself. What is it that Peggy does every day? Is that nice behavior? No, we don't like that kind of behavior. But Peggy is a good artist. And yes, so she's expecting to win the painting competition. But she's in for a surprise, isn't she? Yes. So when the teacher announces the result, who has won the competition? Wanda Petronsky has won the competition. And the judges said that each one of the paintings was prize worthy. Right? It's not only one, but all of the paintings which she had made. And when the girls looked around, and yes, they could see the dresses that she had described. They could actually see those dresses over there, right? And of course, here, yeah, one more thing that happens. Yeah, Wanda has been announced the winner. Everybody is very happy. They're clapping just like you all behave when the results are announced, right? But is Wanda there? No, Wanda is absent. And has Wanda been coming to school? When do Peggy and Maddie realize this? When do they realize it? When the letter comes? No, before that also they realize that she's been absent. How do they realize that? Because they were late to school. They would wait for her outside the school and yes, to ask her the questions. But that day they were late for the class and they realized that, oh, Wanda did not turn up. We had to ask her questions, right? Now, when you stop someone, you're asking these questions day after day, every day, how do you think it is going to affect the behavior of that person? How is it going to affect that the behavior? Is it going to have a positive effect or is it going to have a negative effect? A negative effect. And if someone behaves like that with you in school, would you like coming to school? No, you would not like coming to school. Will you stop coming to school because someone is asking you questions and someone is teasing you? What should you do? You should complain. Okay, right. And you know what? It is not only that people who are very, you know, short and frail and weak, they are the ones who are bullied or who are teased. It can be someone who is very strong and tall build. Even they can be teased and bullied, right? So person who is a bully does not discriminate on that, right? Why do we generally assume that people who are stronger and muscular, they are the ones who bully? Because of the physical strength? That's what we think? Yes? But it can be the other way round also. Yeah, so if this keeps on happening every day, yeah, the child needs to complain. Talk about it at home and talk about it to your teachers, right? And most importantly, yes, be assertive at least once. Just stand up against that person. And you will really realize that how strong that person is. These things are very common in our class. Does it happen in your class from 10th A? We're all very well-behaved students. We don't tease anyone. We don't make fun of anyone. Never? Honestly? Oh, really? What a dishonest answer. Right? So, of course, sometime or the other, we have called someone name and we love calling each other names. We have names that even the teachers are not aware of. What we call each other. Right? Yeah, look at her. He's agreeing. He's saying, yes, of course, we are there. So it is, of course, not a nice thing. If you're doing it in a fun way, of course, in a friendly way, that's a different thing. But we know that line has to be there. That border has to be there. You want to show something? Right? So we should know where the limits are. Now what happened here? Wanda must have gone. Do you think Wanda went home and complained to her father? Then why did her father write this letter? Because Miss Mason had something very serious to announce. She read the letter in the classroom and she told that, yes, there is something very serious and she was very upset with her class and the gestures that she makes, you know, the pause that she takes in reading the lesson, the time that she takes for the class to settle down, all that, it shows that she is very disappointed with the students. She wants to make them realize their mistake. And then she reads a letter which has been written by Wanda's father, and he has decided to shift his daughter and son from this school. They're going to shift to a bigger city, right? Where people will not make fun of their names. And of course, here, where in bigger cities, we feel that there'll be more people like them, more, you know, like people from different communities, and people don't stare at them and people don't ask them their names, right? So two things have happened. One, Wanda's won the competition, but Wanda is not there to receive her medal. Second, Miss Mason reads the letter, and Wanda has shifted her school. She's not going to continue over there. Right. Yes, sir. Now, what happened is that immediately after reading the letter, Maddie and Peggy, do you think they feel guilty about the behavior? Do they feel guilty? Who feels more guilty? Maddie. And of course, here, if Maddie had ever stopped Peggy once, do you think Peggy would have listened to her? What was Maddie afraid of? That if I tell her, don't tease Wanda, she might start teasing me. Because even Maddie did not belong to a very, you know, like wealthy family. And yes, she did not wear beautiful dresses like Peggy did. In fact, some of the dresses were Peggy dresses, right? Which her mother had, you know, like redesigned by adding some frills and laces and things like that. One thing here, do we make friends on the basis of their name? On the basis of their appearance? On the basis of the color of their skin? On the basis of the community they belong to? Then why do we make fun of people? Why is it difficult for us to accept people who are different from us? And here Wanda's father says that I've gone to the bigger city. Do you think in bigger cities, people have more tolerance? People are more accepting than smaller cities? How? Because there are many people like them. So why can't this awareness be created in small cities then? What? Uneducated. All the people in small cities are uneducated. Then we have educated people behaving like this also. What does it show? It shows our ignorance. It shows our lack of awareness, right? And even in our own country, you know, we are not aware about much about the customs and traditions and the behavior and the beliefs of people from other states and communities. So when we look at someone who is different, you go to a shopping mall and you see someone from another community, like dressed differently. What are you going to do? Honest answer, what are you going to do? You're going to walk by, I don't care, you're going to stand and stare. You will stand and stare for a moment, right? And if we see foreigners, then of course we have to take a long glance. You take a selfie also. Okay, fine, right? So we do show that, yeah, we have noticed that this person is different. So in a way, it is our ignorance that comes in the way. Now here, Maddie and Peggy, they have realized their mistake. Maddie wants to say sorry. She thinks that maybe Wanda has not left this place and there is a chance that I can go and say sorry to her, right? And of course, although they talk about the study period was there, but right, Maddie was unable to concentrate and she was just thinking how she could go and say sorry. And when the period was over, when the day was over, she was surprised to realize that Peggy was also having the same thoughts. Peggy, who appears to be very casual and who appears, you know, least bothered. So somewhere she was having that feeling of guilt. So where did both the girls go to? Where did Wanda Petronsky live? Which part of the city? Boggins Heights. So it was not, you know, like a very developed area. It was a little far off because when Wanda used to walk all the way from school, by the time she reached, her shoes would be covered with mud, and especially on wet, rainy days. So when they went over there, they went to that area And of course, there was a slight rain also, and it was making everything even more dull and gloomy, just like, you know, their thoughts at the moment, like the realization that they have done something wrong. In a way, do you think these girls felt guilty that we also teased Wanda that maybe that is why she's left the school? So at the back of the mind, that realization was there. So they went to Boggins Height. They found Wanda's home. But yes, they went, they knocked at the front door. They went to the backyard. But Wanda and her family, they were not there because they had left. What did they notice about Wanda's house? Yes, it was an old house, right? It was not very well taken care of, but it was very clean, just like Wanda's dresses, right? So yes, so when they did come back, and Maddie had this thought, right? One thought was that she will never ever allow anybody to tease or bully. So I think so. If this realization comes to you, if you realize your mistake, I think so half your work is done, right? And of course, if even once you just stand up and have the courage to stop someone, that shows how brave you are. Like, of course, say something is happening in your class and someone is there teasing someone because of the dress or appearance or whatever, right? And even if one of you just stands and stops that person, for that moment, yes, you might feel that people are not going to like me. I might not be so popular. But at least you have stopped something wrong from happening. So it's a very important thing that in life we should learn to stand up. And sometimes children are targets here because they are helpless. And it's so easy to, you know, like dominate children. We have read about even online games also. We're reading about, you know, security issues here, cyber security and all that. Even online games also where children are, you know, like coerced into doing things, right? I think so that game was there quite popular, Blue Whale. Yeah, right? So we have read about that. So one thing is there, if something is there making you feel disturbed, if something is there making you feel unhappy, every day there is a need to talk about it, okay? So what did Maddie and Peggy do? What did they decide to do? They wrote a letter to Wanda, right? And right, of course, that means they were quite smart enough. And they wrote the letter to the same address where Wanda lived. And on the top of it, they wrote, please forward. So that the post office people, if they had the forwarding address where she has shifted to, and every day they would wait for the reply. Did the reply come? No. And yes, so finally, it was the last day of school before the winter break, right? For the Christmas break. And that was when the teacher told them that she's received the letter, right? So there's a letter from Wanda. And Wanda has told about her school, how like that school, like she's like the teacher is not as good as her teacher. And yes, and she said that one thing in particular, two paintings she wanted to give. Whom did she want to give those paintings to? Maddie and Peggy, right? So one she wanted to give to Maddie and one she wanted to give to Peggy. And of course, when Maddie went home, she immediately, you know, like put that painting on her wall, right? And of course, like her house is also described, her house was also not, you know, like very well maintained or right? And she immediately put it on the wall. And when she looked at the painting very, very clearly, there was something that she noticed. What she did she notice about the painting? That, yes, yeah, it is there, like her face was there, right? There was a resemblance of that face to hers. And so she was so happy and she was so surprised and, you know, like very surprised at this revelation or this thing that she noticed. She immediately ran to Peggy's home. And then she told Peggy also to look at her painting. And Peggy was very casual, you know, like she just kept the painting and she thought, okay, Wanda has replied to us. She has said sorry. And in fact, Peggy also goes to the extent that because we used to tease her, that is why she's made 100 dresses. So in a way, we encouraged her. So like, of course, we noticed that her guilt is not as dominant as Maddie's guilt. So when she looks at her painting, what does she notice? Her face, right? So in a way, in spite of being bullied or in spite of being teased every day, do you think Wanda considered these two girls as her friends? Yes, that is why when she made the painting, she made those two girls, right? She made those dresses for those two girls, right? So even though she did not have any friends, maybe she did not talk to them, but Wanda thought of these two girls as her friends, right? So this is where the chapter ends. The girl is looking at the picture and realizing that their faces have been drawn. And when we look at Wanda, or when we realize about Wanda's behavior, we realize that although she was that tight-lipped, polished girl, as it has been described, right? Not very well-built and strong, but there was something about her which was much more stronger than the other girls. Right? She was Do you think it is so easy to forgive? It's not. But Wanda, right? Which made her much brave than Maddie and Peggy, right? So this chapter here, I would say it's one of the best chapters because it teaches us a very important value. One is about acceptance. Let us widen our horizons. Let us widen our thoughts. Life is much more than, you know, like, of course, dividing people on the basis of their name and the color and the community and the background, etc. So when you go to professional colleges, right, that realization happens, right? When if you do move out of the city and the state, then you realize that, yes, I have come across people from different cultures. And of course, do you think we should appreciate this diversity that we have? Yes. Do you think that appreciation, it should be on paper or it should be real also? How can we make it possible in our lives? This appreciation, this acceptance, how can we make that? What are you supposed to do? What do we know about the different states or the different parts? Wanda and her brother, they were teased because they belong to a different community altogether. People did not know that they have names like this, right? So that is why they were made fun of, right? So how can we increase our awareness? We should be aware, at least be aware of the people of your country. Let us learn about their dresses. Let us be aware of their culture. Let us learn about their festivals. Let us learn what kind of names they have, right? So we are there, right? Of course, how we read about, you read about in your geography, you read about in your other chapters here, that how we have this diversity. So we need to accept that, we need to appreciate that. And yes, next time when we see someone who is not like us, someone from a different state or, you know, like with appearance and celebrating a festival which we are not unaware of, let's read about it. Let's try to find about it instead of making fun of that, right? Okay. And of course, here we have also learned about that how bullying, it can lead to serious effects, right? So teasing someone every day, day in, day out is not something nice, okay? Right? If something like this happens in your life, what are you supposed to do? It's because you people are comfortable. You've known each other for so many years. You've grown up together. And if an outsider comes to your class, how easy is it going to be for you to accept it? Or how difficult is it going to be? Yes? Is it going to be easy? Or are you going to ignore that person? We already have our friends and we don't have time for, you know, like getting comfortable with other people. Is it? So we should be tolerant. We should open our minds towards new people, new cultures. This is what this chapter is about. So I expect you're going to read it. And of course, your test is going to be from these two chapters on Monday. Plus, you might get a few questions of grammar also, multiple choice questions. Determiners we have discussed. You might get a few questions from that also. Okay? Right? Any doubts, any questions? Yes, the questions over there at the back.